Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 40 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 71 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 72. You have an Azure subscription that contains a storage account named Storage 1. The subscription is linked to Azure Active Directory tenant named contoso.com that synchronizes to an on-premises Active Directory domain. The domain Active Directory domain contains the security principles shown in following table. So what Active Directory domain contains? That contains a user, which is the user one, and it contains a computer, which is the computer one. In Azure Active Directory, you create a user named user2. So Azure Active Directory contains user2. The storage one account contains file share, share one, and has following configuration. Let's scroll down. And this is the configuration here, which is the storage account type and some of the details. And definitely contoso.com is being used as domain controller. Again, in answer area, we can see three statements are given: that you can assign the storage file data SMB share contributor role to user one for share one. So keep in mind this contributor role or this entire role is the RBAC role, role-based access control feature of the Azure. So statement 1 is asking that can we assign a RBAC role to user 1 for share 1. Second statement is asking that can we assign RBAC role to computer 1 for share 1. And statement 3 is asking that can we assign RBAC role to user 2 for share 1. So first understand by the diagram that how Azure Active Directory sync works. This is something how the Azure Active Directory and Active Directory domain services on-premise looks like. So these are the user identities or group identities are being synchronized using the Azure domain sync. So this is the Azure Active Directory tenant, and this is the domain controller on-premise. It is having some computers on it. And this is connected through AD connect, and Azure is having its own infrastructure in place. So what's happening here is that whatever the user on Active Directory, in this case here the users of Active Directory are being synchronized between AAD or Azure Active Directory, and Azure Active Directory users are being synchronized to the Active Directory on premise. So users and groups are being synchronized. So these both information is being shared between both. So this is how it works. So again, the computer is not being synchronized to the Azure Active Directory. Therefore, this identity is not available on the Azure Active Directory. That we have to keep in mind. So the core concept for this question in the exam are that Azure Active Directory and Active Directory users are synchronized. Therefore, we can assign the role-based access control of Azure Active Directory permission to AD users and AAD users. So both the users can have permissions assigned. So RBAC permissions we can assign therefore to user 1 and a user 2 as well. The computer accounts don't have an identity on Azure Active Directory, therefore we can't configure Azure role-based access control, means RBAC, for them. However, computer accounts can access the file share by using default share level permissions, so which is called access control list on Windows. So that can be used to access the files, but RBAC role cannot be implemented or assigned to the computers on Active Directory. Again, the second reason on the same computer is that cannot assign Azure RBAC role to a computer in ADDS because Azure RBAC role are designed to be assigned to users, groups or service principals only. So this is another limitation. There are two limitations for computers. And the fourth item is that Azure Active Directory is synced to on-prem. Hence, user two will also be in Azure or Active Directory as well. I hope the concept is clear now. Let's go to the question. Now, statement one can easily be answered because this user one is the Active Directory user and residing on, because synchronization in place, so we can assign the RBAC role. Yes. And computer one, as we know, it's part of Active Directory domain services, which cannot be assigned because its identity is missing on the Azure Active Directory. And next one is user two, that is also Azure Active Directory user and can be synchronized with the Active Directory, and there is synchronization in place, so information is available on both and easily can be assigned the permissions or RBAC role on this. I hope I was able to explain this question properly and this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.